Hey viewers, welcome to Get Smart Technologies. This is Ganesh. Today I have brought you the video which is again about the common network protocols which deals with the subject computer networks. My previous video was about DNS which is also a network protocol. You can find the link in the description. Now let's move on to the topic SSH which is called as Secure Shell. So, we are going to deal with Secure Shell. What is this Secure Shell? Why do we need this Secure Shell? What is it all about this Secure Shell? Let's see. This is the definition of the Secure Shell. Secure Shell is a cryptographic. You can clearly see that Secure Shell uses cryptographic network protocol. It itself a cryptographic network protocol for operating network services securely over an unsecured network. Here, unsecured network is nothing but the internet. So, the definition clearly says that the Secure Shell protocol helps to send a data from a client to server securely. Why we need this security? What will happen if there is no security during the data transfer? Let's see. Now let me show you what are the things that will happen when there is no SSH. The things that will happen is IP spoofing, DNS spoofing, password security, that is password security can be breached. Fake routes can be created to hack the data. Connection hijacking is possible. So, these two types of spoofing is possible and data can be easily hacked. And password security is a very common one which can be easily predicted or having many softwares to break the password. So, the data can be easily hacked by the hackers or fake routes can be created and the data can be easily hijacked. So, there is no security for the data which is transferred between the client and the server. So SSH is the shield which protects the data and makes sure there is a safe passage between the client and the server for the data. Now let me show you the process which is happening when there is an SSH, that is the data transferring process when there is an SSH. SSH is nothing but a secure protocol. I have already told that it creates a tunnel passage for the data. Tunnel passage means a safe passage for the data to be sent from server to client or client to server. Now consider ABC is the data which has to be reached to the client from the server. That data is sent through the tunnel connection, a safe passage which is created by the SSH, and in that safe passage the data ABC gets encrypted into symbols like dollar sign, whatever it may be, it gets encrypted so that the hackers cannot be knowing what is the data and it cannot be hacked. So the encrypted form of data gets transferred through the tunnel and reaches the client and it gets demodulated into the original data. So modulation is done over here into an encrypted form and demodulation is done over here. By this way, the data is passed from server to client by using the SSH. As the last part of this video, I will show you how the connection is done between the client and server through SSH. Initially, the client sends the server the connection. So, it initiates the connection, the client, not the server. So, first step of the process is client initiating the connection to the server. The next step is pairing key. Pairing key is nothing but the server creates a key and sends to the client, and the client should be matching the key which is created by the server. In most of the Bluetooth connections, the pairing mechanism is happening, so you will be aware of it. The third one is the negotiating parameters and open source channel, that is the parameters and set of rules between the client and the server. Data passage will be discussed and then the connection will be made. Then the user have to log in to the server host. that is just a formal login. An admin will be there and he will be having a password and a set of security questions, and he will be opening the system and he will be able to access all the data. This is how the connection between the client and the server is made sure in the SSH. Thanks for watching the video, guys. I hope you have understood what is SSH. If you have any doubts, please leave your doubts in the comment box below the video. Please do subscribe to the Get Smart Technology channel to get more videos regarding Arduino, computer networks and software, aptitude, cricket, software and technologies, and many more videos and many more categories of videos. Please do subscribe and press the bell symbol near to the subscribe button so that you can be getting notification whenever I put a video. Thanks for watching, guys. Please do support.